Running a small business can be tough, but you don't have to do it all alone. In fact, ChatGPT can save you an awful lot of time and energy. So in this video, I'm going to share with you 7 different ways in which ChatGPT can help you and your small business. First up, dealing with customer complaints or very angry messages. So all I'm going to do is give it the prompt, reply to this email, and I'm going to put colon. That colon is actually very helpful because you're giving direction up front, and now we can just include any details that we want. And in this case, I'm going to just paste the email that was sent to me. In this example, the customer is very angry. It's been 3 days since I was trying to do something. I don't have access to your portal. My accountant is very angry. I need this ASAP. Let's see what ChatGPT says as part of their response. And in just a matter of seconds, ChatGPT has produced an excellent formatted response to this complaint. Now, of course, you could write such an email yourself, but are you going to remember to be apologetic at both the beginning and the end of the email? And are you going to think of some of these solutions yourself? For example, in this reply, it states, "In the meantime, I can send you your past invoices via email and you can forward them to your accountant." I might not even have thought of the solution myself. I might have just tried to get them to log into their account directly again and again. But in this case, it's more forward thinking. And even if they don't want to go down this route, it makes me sound very supportive and comforting to this particular client. So ChatGPT is not only going to save you an awful lot of time, it may actually give you some additional support ideas for your tougher clients. Number 2, ChatGPT can be a great way to quickly calculate your return on investment. Let's say that you're thinking about purchasing a new piece of hardware or a new piece of equipment, and you've got some basic estimates or basic data in terms of how much it's going to cost to operate and how much expected revenue you should anticipate. So in this case, I've just told it, calculate the ROI of the following, colon. Again, we're seeing this pattern of giving it some brief instructions, and then we can simply either paste in that information or give as much details as possible. The price of my equipment is here. I think it's going to cost about this much per month, and I'm anticipating that it will bring in this much per month. So, should I go ahead and purchase this piece of equipment? Now, of course, ChatGPT can easily make these calculations, but what I appreciate is that it walks me through the steps so I can go back and see exactly what it has done. So under cost of investment, it's showing me the combination of the cost of the equipment along with its operating costs over the next 12 months, and then it's showing me my expected total increase in revenue over the next 12 months as well. Down below, using that formula, we can see it is a positive 28.7%, meaning that for every dollar invested into this new piece of equipment, I can expect a return of 28.7 cents. So this is going to help me make that decision. Is that enough to go forward with this particular investment, or do I need to do some further investigation? Next on our list, we're going to look at using ChatGPT to produce a product description. Now, this is a particular area that I find very, very difficult, and also very, very time consuming. And depending on the number of products or services that you offer, or how often you update those services, you may find yourself bogged down by writing and rewriting these descriptions over and over again. In this example, I've asked it to write a product description for the following: an 8-week group coaching course where you'll learn how to optimize your project management software and spend less time at your office. As you can see, I've only given it one descriptive sentence. Let's see what it comes up with. Now, I won't waste your time reading out the full description. You could always go ahead and pause the video at this point if you'd like to read it in its entirety. But what I appreciate about this product description is just by taking a few key words, it fleshes out the description description with things that are relevant to this particular topic. So for example, in this line, it says you will also have the opportunity to connect and network with other like-minded professionals who are facing similar challenges and share your experiences and successes. It's also adding keywords such as you'll be able to work smarter, not harder, and achieve better results in less time. All of this just based on a very brief description. Now, like with most things that we ask ChatGPT, you're not going to simply copy and paste this and now put it on your website or throw it into a social media post, but it gives you a fantastic template, a great starting point where you can adjust some of the wording and some of those sentences, but roughly 80% of the work is already done for you. And best of all, it might even give you some new ideas that you hadn't thought of before. Now, I know we've already talked about replying to an angry customer complaint or a customer support issue, but another way that I love to use ChatGPT is for formulating follow-up emails. What am I talking about? Well, you're probably already in a discussion with a potential customer or client, but they haven't responded to your last message. Maybe it's been a few days and you need to provide a follow-up, but you need to change it up each and every time. Otherwise, you're going to come across sounding like a robot yourself. So what we can use ChatGPT for is to create a new follow-up message based on the previous message. So in this prompt, I've asked it, write a follow-up email to this message, colon. Again, you're starting to see a recurring pattern. And then I've simply just pasted in this email, a message that I wrote to Jane about 2 days ago. And in just a few seconds, ChatGPT has produced a great follow-up email, which is repurposing some of my earlier words and some of my earlier thoughts, but in a newly formatted email. So I've saved an awful lot of time. I haven't just sent a one-sentence reply, which can often come across as cold to a potential client, but it's something that I can use and get on with the rest of my day. Now, pay special attention when it comes to the results within ChatGPT. In this particular example, you can see that it has put in some boilerplate information. So thank you for considering, in brackets, company name for your office move. You would definitely not want to just copy and paste this entire message and send this as is. This is your opportunity to include your company name. So always be sure to read through and make any minor adjustments as necessary. Now, in addition to replying to lengthy emails or writing product descriptions, ChatGPT can save you an awful lot of time when it comes to communicating via a newsletter. I don't know if you're anything like me, but I often scrutinize my words and my sentences, and writing my weekly newsletter takes an awful lot of time. But ChatGPT can get you there so much quicker and actually do most of the writing for you. In this example, I've asked it to write an email newsletter on the following topic. And in this case, the topic is never spend more than 1 hour per day in email. In this example, I've purposely given ChatGPT something very short and specific, and let's see how it does. Now, one of the bonuses when you ask ChatGPT to write any type of email for you, whether it's a newsletter or a reply or a follow-up, is that it will often include a suggested subject line. And that's exactly what it's done for me here. Subject: boost your productivity, never spend more than 1 hour per day in email. Now, yes, it sort of took that exactly from my prompt, but now, as you can see in real time, the rest of this newsletter is coming together really, really well. Not only has it got an eye-catching opening paragraph, but it's starting to break things down by bullet points down below. So I don't even have to come up with the tips or the tricks or the suggestions in this particular case. Maybe you're wanting to address a certain subject that you're not an expert in, but you can still provide quality tips or advice. Again, this can be a fantastic framework for you to start start with, allowing you to only make a few minor edits before you send out that weekly newsletter. Now, where you may find ChatGPT most helpful is helping with things that you don't do frequently, things that you may only do once or twice a year. And a good example of that could be posting for a new job or writing a job description. In this example, I've given it the following prompt: write a job posting for this position, dental office assistant, part-time, minimum experience is 2 years. And what is so great is that with just 3 pieces of information, it's produced a fantastic job description, including a breakdown of all of the responsibilities and all of the qualifications in bullet points. Yes, it's included the minimum 2 years that I required, but it's also adding all of the other factors that you would expect for an office assistant, including strong organizational and time management skills, excellent communication and customer service skills. So I don't have to think about all of the skills that I need or what a standard position would require. Of course, I can edit and adjust any of this information, but this alone has probably saved me up to 30 minutes of time in my day, especially if I'm only needing to post a job once in a while. Next up, we're going to be taking a look at something that most of us don't include when we're sending out meeting invitations, but we know that we should, so we can have a more effective meeting, or at the very least, have it during the meeting so we can stay on track. And that is developing a meeting agenda. In this example, I've given it the following prompt: create a meeting agenda for a 45-minute meeting to discuss the new product launch that is now 2 weeks behind schedule. Let's see what ChatGPT comes up with. Now, one of the great things about using ChatGPT for your meeting agenda is that it will do the math for you. And in this example, it realizes that we're talking about a touchy subject, that we're behind when it comes to our release date, so we're going to have to solve some problems in this 45-minute meeting. So not only has it broken down the different components from an introduction to status update, impact, action plan, and then next steps, but I love how it's given the most amount of time to the action plan, because aren't meetings supposed to be actionable? This is where we're going to decide what we're going to do next and get ourselves back on track. But it doesn't ignore the other important elements of the meeting as well. In addition, it's included things such as date, time, and location. And of course, we could insert attendees as another option as well. So I could almost copy and paste this entire thing and just plug it into my calendar invitation or into an email, and we are almost done. Not only are you saving time, but you've got a fantastic framework to work with. Now, if you're a small business owner and you love saving time, you're going to want to watch this video next, where I show you how to send and receive text messages directly from your desktop so you can ignore your phone and just focus on your most important conversations.